हेलो एवरीवन, कुछ ज़्यादा ही बड़ा लंच हो गया लगता है। अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 1.5 घंटे का लंच था एंड 1.5 घंटे में कम से कम 150 रसगुल्ले तो खा सकते। प्लास्टिक लास्ट डे। ओके ओके, सो लास्ट 1.5 घंटे से मैं वेट कर रहा था कब मेरा नंबर आएगा, कब मेरा नंबर आएगा, प्रेजेंट करते हैं। सो फाइनली इट्स देयर, सो आई एम हेयर। सो माई सेल्फ दिव्या। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक ऑन वन ऑफ द वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड एट द सेम टाइम वेरी डिफिकल्ट टॉपिक इन एनी बिजनेस स्ट्रैटेजी और यू कैन से ग्रोथ। सो इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट टॉपिक एंड इन फैक्ट देर इज़ नो वन आंसर टू दिस टॉपिक and there is no one solution, one template which you can follow in your business and you can get the traffic and growth in your business via this organic medium. So whatever I am going to present may be debatable. You might think this will work, this might not work, but this worked in my cases and based upon my learnings I am sharing what I learned, how I have grown my business. So there are a lot of ways are there to increase organic traffic on your website, and the ways which I am going to discuss here are maybe one or two of those ways. So as I said, we are here to discuss on how to generate organic traffic on a new website or a new blog. So how many of you have recently launched your new website? Okay, how many have maybe launched 1 year or 2 year back? Okay, great. So I have also launched around 5 websites or 5 businesses you can say in last 10 years, and almost all the websites were failed, all the businesses were failed. So these are the learnings that 98% of the websites which starts fails in the first 6 months of its existence only. Anyone, any idea or anyone wants to share why websites fail or why businesses fail?
Like first 6 months are generally not to be counted at all, mm-hmm. because of the Google dance. Mm-hmm. You only count it after the 6 months.
Okay.
And in fact, we have launched micro websites. Mm-hmm. So we have been able to come on the 3rd and 4th page.
Okay.
In Google.
Okay. Great. Any other views? Okay. Very good. Anyone wants to try? You mean discovery of this? Okay, great.
Hello, Rohit here. There are many reasons for new website or blog fails. The first one is a less traffic. Someone just directly give up because they didn't get the traffic that is expected. And the second thing that I personally think that the people start making the website, they don't have enough knowledge. For example, in the past, I had tried, some of my friends said like a fitness blog is very good niche. Mm-hmm. So I started making the website. Okay, initially I had a few contents I created, and later on that I don't have enough knowledge about that. Mm-hmm. So I guess this is the one reason that people started the website but didn't have a depth of knowledge of that niche. So that's one of the reason.
Yeah, very good. So primarily, like what all websites I have launched was many of them failed because of the one of the reason which you said just now. So what I did is I was crazy about the idea. So I quickly went on Google and I opened GoDaddy and I booked the domain in that day itself. So like I booked the .com domain, then I booked the .in, .co.in, .org, thinking maybe someone will steal my idea and let's book all the domain first and then we will think of the next stage. So in the first day itself, I bought like 5 to 6 domains. And the second day, what I started doing is I installed WordPress, very easy to use. Then I selected theme. I still remember my first website, which I launched in Impreza theme. So I selected the theme, and theme gives a very good option where you can create the home page, features page, contact us. So I built all the pages. And I really have done no innovation. What I did is, whatever the idea was, I found similar websites on the Google. I copied the content from there and just pasted on my, keep on pasting on my website, doing some changes. So that was the stage two. Third is the critical stage where I was struggling to get traffic. So I was like crazy about the idea. I was seeing success which other companies are making. So why my website is not coming up in Google? Why I'm not getting the visitors on my website? So these are the some of the questions which I was thinking, and then I started reading some articles online. I found some ideas. So what I did is I tried to use a lot of SEO tools, who creates backlinks, who do optimization and all. I started creating Facebook pages. I randomly did multiple posts on Twitter, Facebook. I tried everything. I sent cold emails to some of the email addresses. I invited my friends to visit my website. So I tried everything. And even if after doing all these things, I was getting very less traffic, or maybe you can say negligible traffic. So there was no real success was there. So after that, I read about Google Ads and all these things. So I thought, let's put some money in advertisement also. Maybe my site will start ranking. I will get a lot of traffic. So I burned some money in Google Ads, Facebook Ads, everywhere. So that is what my journey was there. So what really went wrong in all these things? So maybe I am a very fresh startup who doesn't know anything about how to build a business, how to build a website, how to get traffic. So let's see what are those learnings. So I found there are only two problems because of which these five businesses failed. And that was, I was really not able to understand what was the real user problem was. And I never try to validate that problem with what service or product I am offering to the users. So that is the two thing which was missing in all these five websites or the businesses which I launched. So that was the learning. So what I did is I didn't stop with these five. So we all know entrepreneurship is a journey. And it doesn't stop with one idea or one product or one company. So I continued my journey. And finally, in 2015, with some other co-founders, I launched PeppyPost. So it is again same thing, crazy idea. But this time, we know what is the user problem is. So we booked the domain. We created the website on WordPress. Till now, the stage was same. But right now we know what is the user problem. So what we did is we focused on the user problem. So the entire, when we are focusing on the user problem, the entire strategy, whether it's marketing, growth, everything started evolving around this the user problem. So a lot of websites or a lot of businesses doesn't focus on this. They try to copy some or the other product and they started selling, saying we are cheaper than this XYZ. But they really don't know what is the user problem and how to address that. So that is where a lot of businesses fails. And because of this, when we started learning about these user problems, from there we started getting attracted towards this concept of organic. So when we are understanding the user problem, we started talking about those user problems whether it's in conferences, whether it's online, offline, wherever. So we started talking about these problems, and from there is when organic growth started coming in. So what is really this organic means? So this is my one of the best, you can say, philosophy, which helps me understand what is real organic means. So you are seeing here one plant, and so tree. So the roots of this tree are going deep inside the soil. Okay, so let's suppose if I keep on watering this plant every day, so what will happen? The roots will not go deep inside the soil because it is getting water every day. So this root will become at the it will be there at the surface of the soil only. It will not go deep inside the root. But if I water occasionally, or if I will not water, so only two things will happen. Either the plant will die, or it will start learning the art of its root will start learning the art of going deep inside the soil to get the water. So that is where I compare this with business. So water is here, in case of business, it's money. So if you keep on pumping money to your business at the nascent stage, at the start of your company, so this is where lot of things goes wrong, because you will see lucrative things like because of these money which you are pumping, you can get lot of followers on your Twitter, you can increase the page views, you can attract lot of traffic from various sources, but you will really not know the art of organic growth, how user can discover you by themselves, how they can increase the trust value on your brand. So those are the things you will never understand, because you will keep on busy creating the ad copies and publishing in different mediums. So you have to go in a way where your business will self-learn how to attract users towards it. So self-discovery is important for any of the startup or any of the new brands which are coming in. So once you start doing these, so your business will become a lead magnet type of thing, where it will keep on attracting people who are really interested in your whatever product or whatever problems you are talking about. So let's take an example. If someone here is talking about some X problem, and in this audience there are 10 people who are suffering from that particular problem, so they will keep on listening those talks and they will try to come and discuss about those problems. So that is how the attraction comes. So that is what I called it self-discovery. So I am really not a big fan of SEO tricks like doing a lot of optimization with meta tags, doing image optimization, or adding keywords inside your article, so creating backlinks. So you generate content or you write something which is talking about the user problem, and just focus on that. Don't focus on search engine. You are writing for users, not for search engines. Leave the topic of doing optimization and everything aside, because search engines are smart enough today. They are working on these artificial intelligence, and lot of learnings are going on. They will come to know what you have written, what you are talking about. You really don't need any optimization if you are focusing on user problem and working around that. So this is where from this organic theory and everything, so the concept of happy to help content came into my mind. So these are the content which are published to help users. So these are the topics or the content which I am going to write, which are going to talk about the user problems and its solutions. So it's like my brand is always there, happy to help you. So I am not selling any product. What I am selling is the problem and its solution. So all my articles, all my contents, all my talks, everything will be around this particular thing. I am happy to help with the problem and its solution. So I'm giving you some examples here from different scenarios, what type of contents I am talking about. Then I will show you in my brand what contents we have written. So like, let's suppose you are a food startup. So maybe if you can, instead of talking about this restaurant has this particular product, or this restaurant is doing free delivery or something like that, can you write on some of these topics saying, what is the famous street food in Kandivali or Mumbai? What are the food habits which can control weight gains? Whether A2 milk is a good or bad, what is your opinion? So what you are doing primarily here is you are targeting the audience who are interested in food, nutrition, and related things. You are trying to attract those traffic as a magnet towards your website. So these users will start flowing in. And believe me, there is a very high traffic in these keywords. If you will go on Google and you will search for the traffic, what is the traffic on these particular keywords, you will find a lot of traffic. So you will start getting traffic on your website. Now, this doesn't mean they will sign up for your product and they will, whatever the product is, food startup, they will sign up for that and they will start buying the products. This is just one thing. It is self-discovery. They are discovering your brand, writing about something. So what is your next thing is, you have to keep writing about such things. And you have to focus on one metric, that is repeated user on your website. Can you attract the same user again on your website via some of these contents? And once that repeat engine you are able to establish, where users are repeatedly coming to your brand to read some of these articles, is when you will start registering the brand value in the user's mind. And then when they will read about your product on your website, or they will hear something outside, they will immediately sign up for your product or they will buy your service. So this is a slow process. The buying cycle is slow, but the traffic generation cycle is very fast. So if you have, I have given some other examples, like in case of e-commerce startup, you can write some of these topics. So there is a hosting company, which is hosting and I can say data center company, which is very successful via this model. So they are currently writing about these topics, like how to install Ubuntu on Windows machine, how to set up SSH key, how to install Node.js on Ubuntu. Can anyone guess, when you search for some of these things, which brand comes on the top of Google? Correct, absolutely. So this tutorial, so they call it as community tutorial. So this is one of the key strategy because of which their traffic is increasing multifolds every month, every year, and they are just going on. So this is one of the core strategy for DigitalOcean's growth, what they are doing right now. So any topics you will find around technical, like bugs, installations, or whatever, you will find the digital article on the top. So they did this exercise in last 5 years or 6 years, and then is what where they are right now. So for fintech startups, I have again written some sample topics, like how to get loan even if your CIBIL score is low. Lifetime free credit card. A lot of people search for this lifetime free credit card. So can you attract those users on your website if you are a fintech startup? So in case of DigitalOcean, it took around 5 years or whatever odd years to grow to this level. So do you think really increasing traffic via organic means takes lot of time? Any idea, like if you are starting business today and you want to generate traffic organically, how soon you can get the traffic? Two to three weeks. Good. Okay. So we did this experiment with our brand also to generate organic traffic via talking about the user problem and its solution. And what we saw is we can easily generate 1,000 new users every day for B2B businesses and 5,000 new users every day for a B2C business. This is easily doable within 3 months. So it's a cycle. After 3 months, this is the growth which you will be getting. So we experimented this reiterated our experiments, and then finally we are now having the model of this growth where we are increasing multifolds. We are increasing our traffic multifolds every month, every quarter. So, but how? So you have to choose the topics very smartly. So this doesn't mean you have to do keyword research and all this and then start hacking the traffic from here there. Focus on the user problem. What is your user problems are? So I will take an example like PeppyPost, my brand. So it's a cloud-based email delivery platform. So what it does is it do email delivery. So there are a lot of softwares are there in globe which do the job of email delivery. And there are a lot of challenges which happens while delivering the email. Sometimes it lands in spam, sometimes it lands in inbox, sometimes the mails is delayed, sometimes it's lost. So there are a lot of such problem statements are there. So there are a lot of open source tools are there via which you can send emails. You can install those and you can send emails. So can we start talking about those problem statements and start attracting those customers, users to our website? Can we build a something tutorial type of thing which can be like a lead magnet and will start attracting those users? So this is exactly what we did on PeppyPost also. So we launched this tutorial series. So it talks about user problem and its solutions. And today we are growing organically because of this approach. So our entire marketing and every strategies are now focused upon user problems. So whatever we talk in various webinars, broadcast, or online, whatever blogs or articles we are writing is now all about happy to help. So if you can adopt some of these things in your brand, when you are launching your brand, I am very sure that you can also start generating traffic. People see value in what you are selling. It's not just you are another product who is cheaper than X and or who are giving some XYZ features and so on. So once you start generating the traffic and you are getting the traffic on your website, there are not many metrics which you have to measure. So there are only 2-3 metrics. If you keep a watch on those on daily basis, you will be able to see whether whatever efforts you are putting in is worth or not. One is, what is the new user growth in your website or blog every day? So you have to keep a track every day how it is growing. How your Alexa ranking is improving. So like in our case, the ranking was something around 250,000 and which came down to now 40,000. And we are targeting it to take it to below 10,000 globally. So any brand who is under 10,000 global Alexa ranking is like one of the, I can say, premium brands in the globe. So that is our target. So, but all this we did in just 3 months. So from 250,000 to 40,000 was done in 3 months because of those happy to help content. Why this, fast increase in the ranking happens in 3 months? Because you are writing something which user is in problem about, and it is being read by a lot of people across the globe. So if there are number of unique countries which is accessing your content will increase, that is when your global Alexa ranking starts increasing. So you have to focus on how many number of new unique users across the globe are reading. So that is where the Alexa rank starts improving. So these are some of the fundamentals which you have to keep a track. And once these users are coming on your website, this next is the metrics which we have to measure is the repeated user coming to your website. So you have to measure this user has visited today. So after 1 month or after 15 days also, this user is coming to your website again or not. So for that, you have to write related articles, or you have to think of the user persona. What might be the other problems in which that user might be? But those problems will be around your industry. That will be good in order to build the brand value. So these are some of the fundamentals which we applied in our business, and we are seeing a growth. So today, PeppyPost is quite successful, sending 8 billion emails every month for big brands like HDFC, Ola, Flipkart and all. So, and it is spreading globally. So I hope that same organic strategy we will be able to continue in our coming years, and we will be able to grow. So thank you so much. Any questions?